entrepreneurship or entrepreneurship? How do you pronounce it? For that, we have Professor Dutta from Birla Global University. Let's ask him. Hello, sir.
Hi.
Sir, can you please tell us more about what is the subject called and what is it spelled as?
Well, the spelling is here, but the pronunciation may be difficult. We Indians often call it as entrepreneurship, but it is basically a French word. And so the correct pronunciation would be entrepreneurship. But you don't go by the pronunciation, go by what this subject is about, because that is fascinating.
Sir, it sounds fascinating. Can you tell us more about it?
Well, this is one of the courses that we have at BGU, and this is one of the few courses in MBA where you have a practical approach. The entire course is done outside the class. We have very limited subjects, theories which are taught in class. Actually, students go through an experience of starting their own business. So we are looking at startups. So each student in a group have to create a own venture, their own small startup. That can be as small as a sandwich shop or a used garments shop, or it can be a NGO starting to help people, volunteer. They do it on their own.
Wow, sir. Is it limited to MBA students only?
Well, right now, we have been offering this course to the MBA and the BBA students also. But because BGU is a university, we have 5 different schools, and we are following the national education policy, you know, and with that, any student of any school in BGU can select a course of their choice, and this is a basket in the course, and you can take this course as a part. You are maybe a lawyer, you can take a part of this course as entrepreneurship is one of your subjects. That is also possible.
Wow, sir, that sounds really great. But sir, this course is available in a lot of universities. What's so special about it in BGU?
Well, this is an interesting question because at BGU, we have a collaboration with the National Entrepreneurship Network, Wadhwani Foundation. Now, what happens if you have this kind of a collaboration? This is an international organization, Wadhwani Foundation, and they have this particular course being run across 17 different countries, including Africa, Southeast Asia, and we have India. And there are more than 700 institutes in India where this course is running parallel. And they have a learning management system called LearnWise, which the students can access all the reading material, videos, synchronous as well as asynchronous reading material is present in LearnWise. So what the student can do, and they don't have to wait for the class or the professor to take the class. The first they register in, they are given a password and a login name. They can get into the website and then read through that. They can watch videos. They can clear their doubts. There's an app called Wadhwani Advantage. So 24/7, if they have any question, they can access the ecosystem there. So it's not just the teacher from whom they learn. It's also from multiple mentors. There are mentors who are international, juries who are international. So professors or real life business from some other country, they evaluate your ideas. They give you feedback. So what happens is when you start your business, all the problems that you have, you can discuss not just with your professor, you discuss with your friends and the peer group, the huge peer group outside the university also. So apart from that, once you have a final milestone, they call them milestones that you have to go through, after the last milestone, there's an international jury who will evaluate your project. And now what happens if your project, they feel that it's worth converting it to a real life venture, they will give you a certificate. Now this certificate is over and above the certificate that you get from BGU. So this is a certificate from National Entrepreneurship Network. So that adds a lot of value to your CV. And another great thing that this certificate does is it makes you eligible to apply for funds from angel investors or venture capitalists. Now what happens, you are no longer a student who is doing a coursework. Now you are an entrepreneur who has taken a real life business plan to an angel investor and you are asking for funds. And the funds can range from 10 lakhs to even 1 crore. But that is not guaranteed. That will depend on the merit of your business plan. If you have, you have to pitch. And again, the ecosystem will support you in how do you make this business pitch and how do you go about making your proposal. The entire ecosystem will be supporting you. So that way, what happens, this course at BGU is not just a course that ends with your curriculum in the university. It carries on, it helps you to take yourself forward in career, in life.
Wow, sir. So if I'm a student with a startup idea of a good business, the college is actually going to help me manifest it into a business for lifetime.
Right. That is exactly what this course is all about.
Doesn't that sound really interesting? Wow, sir, you have a collection of so many caps. As I've heard, besides being the professor of PGU, you also manage the cultural events in it. So can you please tell us more about it?
Yes, I am also the head of the cultural conduit at PGU. There are many caps, and one of the caps that I wear is being the head of the cultural conduit. So what is cultural conduit? So this is something that happens across the university. You have different schools and the students of different schools, anyone with a cultural bent of mind. So anyone who dances or sings or is interested in photography, blogging or any cultural event that you feel like, or even martial arts, they collaborate together to form a club. And they organize events across the year, throughout the year. Now these events are not just days or festivals which are celebrated across the country. These may be regional festivals, like we have Onam being celebrated here, we have Rath Yatra, we have Rajo of Odisha, and we also have Durga Puja, things like Ganesh Puja. So those festivals are also celebrated in some small way at the campus. And we also celebrate national days like the Republic Day, the Independence Day. And apart from that, we also have small competitions. Like in the evening, we have Mushaira competitions, stand-up comedy competitions. We also have something called Sham-e-Bahar, where these are evenings where we all join together and then exchange our cultural events that we have. We also have a collaboration, or we are also a part of the Spikmati Bhuvaneshwar chapter. So we bring in classical performers, internationally famous Indian classical performers for our, and they come to a beautiful campus and we have open air performances. We have brought in so many ghazal singers, qawwali singers, sitar players, bihu players. So they have come down and shared their cultural talents with us. We also have a yearly competition, and that is inter-school, inter-university competition involving universities and colleges, not just in Odisha but also the eastern part of India. We have colleges participating from Calcutta, from West Bengal. We have people coming from there, and there we have a competition, we have cash prizes, and we also have a star night. That is the annual fest that we have. And we also have a very vibrant sports conduit where they talk about many competitions, both state level as well as college level, university level competitions that we have. So in a manner, BGU students are not just students who just are bookworms who are forced to make
projects and submit assignments. Apart from that, they also have a very vibrant cultural life. And as you said, that is one of the caps that I wear.
That sounds so cool, sir. Don't you really find it amazing that students here at BGU are not just limited to study and study? They can also have fun and express their talent in a lot of ways. But sir, since you know that a pandemic situation is going on right now, how do you manage all this? How do BGU manages all this during this lockdown period?
Well, pandemic is a truth we cannot ignore. Across the world, every nation, every university is going through this strange situation that we never anticipated. But as you know, they say the show must go on. So human beings have always tried to overcome challenges. And biggest challenge that we have is cutting across this boundary of physical distancing and reaching out to the student on the online mode. So we have our classes, most of the classes happening online. So there are so many tools, so many online platforms that we use, and not just for classes. We have tried doing these cultural events on the online platform also. And if you remember, for the BBA students as well as the MBA students who joined in 2020, the pandemic batch, so they had their freshers welcome. That was done entirely on the online platform. So you had people welcoming. So we had more than 100 students interacting together in the online platform, dancing, singing, interacting. And there was there's a rap singer who had recorded a small video of him, and then he actually played it. And for a moment we forgot that we were not together, and it felt that we were all in one small space and we were all connected together. So we are living up to the challenges and we are trying to remove that barrier. And the best part is, with the vaccines coming up and the rate of infection going down, we are very optimistic that this is a temporary situation. And within a few months, we hope that after the vaccination comes in, the schools and colleges will be opening up. And we will also be opening up our campus for people to come in. And you know, we have a wonderful lush green campus of around 30 acres. So when actually students come in there and they fill up the campus, it becomes more and more fun. And you're right, online is not the exact replica of what happens in the physical world. It has got its limitations, but we are making the best of what we have. So, and again, as I said, this is temporary, and maybe a few months, I'm very optimistic about it.
I'm very optimistic about it, and I firmly believe that all of this will eventually get ended very soon and we'll get to meet on the campus. Until then, me Neha.
Me Professor Somnath Datta.
Are signing off from Birla Global University, Bhubaneswar. Thank you.
Thank you.